Hey, we're recording.
And we are back. Oh, that's gonna be fun. Yeah, I'm glad I came up with that. So, you know, I've been having an interest to tell you things. I've been gone away for a minute, so I'd just like to keep y'all updated and such. Otaku Party Alliance is officially conscripted as a enterprise of the United States government. As far along as the United States government, we're live, son. We're live. We're legal. The law can't take it from us no more. That got our own now. So now we have the platform. Which is good. Solid. Solid. But do we have a shit ton of work to do? So much work to do. Oh my god. Is that a penis?
Say was we all make mistakes and appeal to doctors.
Sometimes it's not your dad. But.
Equally as unfortunate, Wright does not seem the person to alleviate the problems that have been observed by multiple commentators. On the contrary, his behavior seems to lead to reinforcement, which I personally believe will not lead to favorable outcomes. This brings me to my second point about Jake's video. The idea that it was best for Jake. The problem is that Greg is solely concerned with Jake, but what is best for Jake is not necessarily best for Team 10. And when you continuously cause people from Team 10 to leave, people inside will inevitably become expendable and lose the draw that they gave to the squad. It becomes Jake Paul and his background dancers, and it will inevitably lead people to question whether there even is a necessity for Team 10. So although people saying Team 10 is falling apart is an exaggeration, it does cause a possible loss of identity. The starting lineup established identity for themselves, and new ones appear to lack that. But either Greg Paul doesn't know or doesn't care. Once again, loyalty matters, but so does logic. It will inevitably become the Jake Paul show, which, if that's what you want, then fair enough, but I don't want more Jake Paul in my life. The idea of Jake Paul having complete free reign is slightly concerning. Whether Jake Paul is conscious of this himself is a different question. But either way, I do not see Greg benefiting Jake as an individual, nor Team 10 as a collective. I'm not saying it's going to happen soon, but if it does, we know why. At the center of the Paul family, we find a man who, although may not be the image of the brand, is certainly exerting influence on a day-to-day basis, either over his sons, over an audience, or over others around him. Whether that influence is positive, as I present today, is highly tentative, and the means that he uses to exert it, even more dubious. That man is Greg Paul. What do you think of the situation? What is exactly going on here? I would love to hear what you think. Leave your comments down below, I'm always interested to hear. You can also reach me on Twitter, at The Right Opinion. You can reach me on Facebook, I'll leave the links there. And you can also reach me on Discord too, I'll put my server in the link below. You can reach out to me through any of those mediums, I tend to respond to all of them, I do my best to be a responsive gentleman. Also, big shout out to the editors, they've once again done a stellar job, and I'm just imagining right now how this is going to look. And oh yes, that's very pleasing indeed. Also, big thanks to Woody1 and RD Benji. Whether invited or uninvited, I appreciate them nonetheless. Anyhow, love to hear your thoughts once again. Until then, however, I'm The Right Opinion, and I'll see you in the next one. Hello, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to The Right Opinion, the home of a twat with too much free time. And boy, don't we have a topic that everyone was anticipating me to cover. Well, looky here, now you get your wish. I had a few topics to pick out of the hat, but I found such a fascinating one today that I couldn't possibly ignore it. And it's obviously in part about the titular character, Mr. Shane.
Is that a helicopter?
Shane Dawson, like a lot of people we talk about on this channel, is a YouTuber. I'm sure many of you are already aware of this, but if you somehow just discovered this platform and you've had the pleasure of this beautiful accent introducing you, that's what he is, a YouTuber. But he's not just any old YouTuber. He's
He's one of the first YouTubers to get comments on the platform. This was I thought so. This is so bullshit. Why would you put so much detail into it if I can't fly?
YouTuber on the platform, which you know I'm not complaining about. Anyhow, that was a simpler time, but as a creator, it is necessary to evolve with the times. So as charming as these sketches and short films were, it appears that they will come to an end on that channel at the close of 2016. What took its place, though? Well, his third channel, Shane. Yes, he had three channels. Busy bloke. Now, Shane was originally set up as a vlog channel. In the day, it was almost like a backup for him, letting his followers know what's up and what's going down, with little jokes and memes. Nonetheless, still with some pretty saucy clickbait. There was no throwaway thumbnail to Shane, it seems. Anyhow, in case you haven't noticed, with the increasing accessibility to high-quality equipment, vlogging has emerged in the past few years as a huge genre. Along with this, other genres that crept into the public eye are mystery genres, list genres, and commentary. Therefore, Shane did what any person with a level head would do in those situations, and made this Shane channel dedicated to morphing all of those genres together, which is pretty damn genius. Although, as a creator, Shane was definitely aware of the consequences of mixing a range of genres that are too diverse from each other, and something that his associate Bobby Burns would soon find out. And so he tended to mesh them in a very similar style that would bring back the audience for each video, allowing organic views to turn into suggestions. would grow out some great content that had mass appeal to the multitudes of audiences, dedicated and casual. I assume he chose this channel probably because it had the best potential fan base. And as said, if you tried to mix these views with already established content in a rather distinctly incompatible style, the algorithms loathe it. So I believe this was a smart move. On top of this, he would make some more personal videos that would branch out his character and the relationship that he had with the audience. In a way, he was building an empire. The Shane brand not just being an interesting expansion of content for him, but also branching out on the elements of his character, dissecting his childhood, relationships, and asking a lot of questions with no clear answers. It's emotionally riveting stuff. It really is. I feel, therefore, it was an appropriate succession to continue into these documentary-style videos that deal with many of the components that Shane had dealt with in the past, just in a more bombastic fashion, and under the guise of an individual problem or person, which is then branched out to implicitly deal with other questions. That's typically what any video that's not just a basic reaction video will do, but obviously there are tiers to this, and Dawson clearly wanted to do top tier. Now, I recently covered the tea-spilling saga, of which one of the people I covered was Jeffree Star. Jeffree Star has been in the public eye for a while. In fact, he's a very prominent individual, clearly. However, given the sort of brewing tea in that community, it made sense that Shane would be interested in covering such controversial figures. However, in my video, I note that this whole beauty community kind of dominated the summer and pushed other figures like the Pauls into the background, even though they were arguably behaving much worse than any of the beauty commentators in question. So when Shane announced his next set of videos were going to be on Jake Paul, people were a tad surprised. Here's this topic that, in a way, is kind of dead and buried, and if Shane was going to pull out his shovel, he was going to have to dig deep to find some interesting content. Now, there was a natural air of hype surrounding this, following the success of both his previous series, and this gave it a natural boost. But the first episode was rather low-key for him, and the second one came out, and although no one could deny it was fantastic production value, there were some critics who felt that what he was discussing was fairly unnecessary. Why is that? Well, for a multitude of reasons, but we'll try and break them down. The first one being that Jake Paul is a dead topic. Everyone has an opinion, love him, hate him, and although Shane can bring the melodrama, which he did without a doubt, weren't going to be filled in with any new narratives. The one that Shane has taken on is whether Jake Paul is a sociopath, which is an interesting narrative, but one he kind of abandoned by the final episode. Jake Paul definitely displays certain traits of a sociopath, and Dawson cleverly leaves each part very open-ended on that question. At the end of the day, we shouldn't be going around diagnosing someone formally, and that is implicitly assumed that nothing is being factually defined here. However, even with that noted, many people question the point and the implications. At the end of the day, what Jake Paul does, whether Jake Paul himself is a sociopath or not, is kind of besides the point. He behaves terribly. I don't make videos that are out to defend people. In fact, I think I criticize more regularly than most gents, and that gets under some people's skins. And then they get annoyed and tell me to make original content and somehow unoriginal. But that's just me being bitchy. What I found quite interesting this time around was that many approached Shane's series with a highly critical eye. I think this was in part due to its size and the ambitions. I think there are a lot of levels that we can analyze on. But this time I'm going to However, the subsequent handling was a mixed bag, but also attempting to be sympathetic towards the criticisms. I think, however, to understand the weight of the Jake Paul series, you have to understand Shane first.
Thank you all for coming.
What to do today.
There are many
discussions about the original series, so I intend to get my video.
Thank you.